The bill before us today is intended to make the tax cap permanent. May I ask the senator when the current bill is scheduled to expire?
I think sometime next year, if I'm not mistaken.
If the senator would continue to yield. I do believe it expires in 2016. The senator is correct. The intent here is to make this permanent. Isn't it correct that at any point in time, this legislature could vote to modify or change this tax cap between now and then, or renew it for any other set period of time, that there is no deadline that requires us to deal with this particular proposal today?
Yeah, that's true, but, you know, why not the present? Why would we wait to get up against the deadline and try to get something passed at the last minute like we do sometimes with the budget? We want to be proactive because it's such a great feature of state government, the 2% tax cap.
Thank you. Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Senator. Senator, we have heard from municipal governments, those that represent village towns and cities and counties, many of which we have served ourselves as councilmen, county executive, county legislator, village trustee, and so forth, that the current property tax cap, which has been in effect for 4 years, exempts capital projects on the school district side, but does not exempt those capital projects on the municipal government side, and that a number of our communities are telling us that the tax cap makes it very difficult for them to undertake the kind of capital improvements that are necessary, from aging infrastructure that winds up going into the cap and making it more difficult for them to be tax cap compliant. Before advancing this bill today, was there a discussion about the possibility of a modification that would satisfy that which we've heard from our villages, towns, cities, and counties?
Yeah, there's been discussions about modifying it in many different ways. Some don't want 2%. Some districts, local municipalities don't want any cap, so they can continue to spend at whatever rate they choose to. It's important to our conference that this 2% cap continue. We could always make modifications sometime later if the consensus is to do that. And the amount of money, the information I've got, that we've saved property owners in school taxes alone by the cap is $1.3 billion. And, you know, that's real money. And most people are very concerned about high property taxes. And the great consensus is that we should keep this thing going. If it could be working better and there's enough consensus, there's a consensus made, we can make modifications like that.
Will the Senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Senator. Given the fact that we have the opportunity not to have the tax cap expire for at least another year, and there have not been detailed public hearings to listen to the experiences now that we've had the cap in place for 4 years, there may be things that you want to point to specifically about the benefits of it, but we have heard that there are very specific concerns about it. Another example of that would be that in the 2011 bill, when this was passed, there was a commitment made for significant mandate relief. Has there been any mandate relief over and above what we have talked about in general that is attached to the extension of this tax cap that's before us today?
Well, I think our moves as far as our state's now responsibility as far as Medicaid costs, that to me is a very significant mandate relief. It's one of the biggest mandates that we have for local government. So I think that's been done. More could definitely be done, but the state should be paying for mandates, and I agree with you. But this is so important. We believe it's got to be continued, and if changes have to be made at a later date. And by the way, just for my own personal district, I get more comments on the cap property tax cap than anything else. People want to keep it going because they don't want to go back in that cycle that we've been going into where ever-increasing property taxes. Also, to the credit of state government, we've been, even though not mandated by law, we've been keeping our state budgets below the 2% cap as well, voluntarily, which provides other savings to the state of New York taxpayers as well.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Senator, there is a bill which Senator Gallivan carries, which would phase out over a defined period of time that Medicaid mandate that you spoke of. Any of us who have any experience in county government know that that portion of mandate relief that has been experienced so far on Medicaid is merely to cap the growth of Medicaid, but that the base charge of Medicaid still runs somewhere between 20% to 25% of the property tax levy of county governments, whether they're a large county government or a small county government. And I'm wondering if in the decision to extend the tax cap as is, there was any discussion of Senator Gallivan's bill and perhaps take some of those provisions and build that in as mandate relief to accompany the extension of the cap.
Well, that bill's also a good bill, and but on the other hand, counties, in order to balance the budget, we have to stay under 2% too. In order to, according to our voluntary 2% cap, there are a lot of needs by a lot of people in this room that we try to fill the gaps on, and sometimes you can't justify hundreds of millions of dollars of additional spending to lower the cost for counties. And the other thing, too, what everybody forgets about this, when Medicaid was first became a responsibility of county governments, there was a corresponding permission to enact their own sales tax. And the sales tax revenues that are coming in are substantial. So if we're going to go that logical step, we pick up the entire cost of Medicaid, maybe that sales tax revenue in return should be given to the state of New York or stopped completely. So it's not like we left the county governments in a lurch. If you look at their sales tax revenues, that's probably their biggest revenue of all. So it's not, you don't just get everything, namely pay the Medicaid and continue to have the benefit you got when the rule for Medicaid payments was made.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Senator. My understanding from most of the counties I speak to is they would gladly give us back the sales tax revenue if we took back their Medicaid mandate. Now, that may not be true for every single county, but everyone I've talked to thinks that that would be a lot better, because the reality of it is that you're paying property tax expenditures for the Medicaid mandate. But I appreciate your answer on the issue. The bottom line is that the extension does not include any additional aid on the Medicaid issue. May I ask, in terms of school districts, the tax cap does not make any respectful modification for school districts where they have increasing enrollment, so that year over year, if a school district has many more students coming in, as some do, there is no exception or consideration made for that. Was that a discussion before the extension was put before us?
No, because when you get increased enrollment, you get increased state aid to education. And with respect to your last point, I think it's a good point. Maybe Senator Gallivan, I'd join with him to see if we could get a quid pro quo from the counties and get the sales tax in return for some further relief on Medicaid.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Thank you, Senator. In many cases, Senator, as we know, there are school districts that receive as little as 5% of direct state aid. So when they have an increasing enrollment, no modification to the tax cap, and a very small amount of state aid, it in fact costs them a great deal whenever they have increasing enrollments. And we've seen that in many of the high-growth suburbs in Westchester and on Long Island. Let me ask, has there been any discussion or consideration about a modification to the tax cap to take into account significant refunds on tax certiorari proceedings, which many times has had a significant impact on county governments, on school districts, and on municipal governments, and it has been argued by those local officials that those should not be calculated as part of their tax cap obligation?
Okay.
Senator DeFrancisco.
I don't know, was that a question?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I missed it. Would you tell me the question part?
I think I started it as they do on Jeopardy in the form of what is.
Senator Latimer, could you pose a question, please?
I will. Thank you, Mr. President. Was there consideration made for the reality that tax certiorari settlements, which are significant dollar impacts, have not been taken into account in the calculation of the tax cap for those governments that give back certioraris that are covered under the tax cap, counties, villages, towns, cities?
I'm sure there were discussions, but it didn't get in this particular bill. And in addition, there's another remedy for those school districts, namely, they can, by a more than majority vote, they can actually raise their taxes a greater part, and if they're larger than 2%, and if it's Westchester County, usually that's a pretty high-value property area, I think.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Senator. Was there any discussion before putting this bill before us as a straight extension about the fact that the tax cap does not take into account if there is a significant DEC consent order upon a municipal government that would require a significant expense to the municipal government where capital is not excluded from the tax cap and the state DEC has required Community A or Community B to spend an inordinate amount of money to fix some particular item as part of a settlement?
There was never really any discussion about that, but if you could look at any jurisdiction, school district, municipality, or whatever, there's always special circumstances, and if we did a bill which included every circumstance where you could violate the 2%, you wouldn't have the 2% cap any longer.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Thank you, Senator. Similarly, was there any discussion about the impact of pilot agreements, payment in lieu of tax agreements that occur that work in also against the tax cap when those come into play?
Well, there's a bill that Senator O'Meara has that would do just that, but once again, it's a local decision whether to do a pilot or not. If the pilot is something that's important enough to bring in new business, then obviously the tax revenues are going to go up. If it's not enough to justify doing with a 2% tax cap, the decision should be made not to do the project.
Thank you, Senator. Mr. President, on the bill?
Senator Latimer on the bill.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Senator DeFrancesco. What we have here is an extremely popular issue. We understand that tax stress exists everywhere in this state, from people who have low income to people who have high incomes. If they have property, they feel stressed by their property taxes. It is also true that when this tax cap was created 4 years ago, it was sunset for a reason. Why do we sunset bills? Because we want there to be an evaluation as to what that bill impact will be. And at the time that that bill was voted on in both houses and passed in both houses, there was a promise made that there would be significant, robust mandate relief that would accompany the bill. The actual bill in 2011 had very little of that. A year later, there was an argument that the pension smoothing proposal was that tax relief that would come, tax relief which was used by one community in the state and no others. What I would argue is we have had the opportunity to look at 4 years of the impact of the tax cap. And the municipal officials, the NYSAC officials, the town officials are not arguing that they want to see the tax cap disappear. They don't like it, but they have raised some legitimate issues that need to be considered before an extension. And to extend it without having that robust debate is not to be fair to the local governments. They are people who have run for public office as we have. They've been elected by the people in their jurisdiction to use their judgment, much the same as we have in being sent here, and much the way that most of us have who've served in other levels of government before we got here. The thought that having been elected mayor of Mineola Village or having been elected a county clerk in Saratoga County or having been elected town supervisor in New Windsor or having been elected to the Rye City Council, that somehow those elected officials can't function intelligently in their respective governments without the state telling them what to do and how to do it, works against everything that we hear all the time in this chamber, that we want to take power and push it down to the local level. So what I would argue, I'm sure unsuccessfully, is that we have a tax cap that is in place for another year. We have identified just the tip of the iceberg of sensible discussions that ought to be held about modifications that could be made. If we vote today to extend the tax cap today, we add no benefit to the taxpayer because the tax cap is already in place for the next 12 months. But what we will do is turn our back on our local officials. And we will be telling those village mayors who we're going to see this weekend, we will be telling those town councilmen that we're going to see this weekend, we didn't hear you. We didn't care what you had to say. We didn't care that we were willing to try to modify and adjust and make some considerations because of that reality. I think what we have today is acting prematurely, and I think acting unfairly to our local governments. I don't think we're treating our local governments and their officials and the school districts with the respect they properly deserve. Having said that, Mr. President, I appreciate your time. Senator DeFrancesco, I appreciate your time, and I will relinquish my time.